Hello ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much indeed for viewing this short screen tutorial on how to answer the Edexcel History Controlled Assessment question for 2014, Part C. Now the Part C question will be the stem, the best representation at showing something. So you need to work out the best of the three representations you're given, irrespective of whatever question that might be. How do we work out though what constitutes best? Well, if I'm your teacher, then the criteria we'll be using this year will be accuracy, objectivity, and completeness. If you're viewing this but I don't teach you, it might be a little different. So please, please, please do ask your teacher first just to make sure that this tutorial is relevant for you. Okay, so if I'm teaching you, it's accuracy, objectivity, and completeness. Now, what do they mean? Okay, accuracy, no surprises there. Is the content, is what it's saying true? Is it factual? And is it accurate? Does it correspond with historical reality? So, what the representation's saying, did it actually happen? If so, did it happen as the representation is indicating that it did? You will need to be able to do this, you'll need to carefully analyse and scrutinise the representations, all three of them, so you can accurately validate the claims that each of them is making. In short, you're going to have to read the representations, check what they're saying, look at what happened in reality by looking at textbooks, asking your teacher, doing your own research, and making sure that what is stated in the representations actually happened in reality. So you're going to need to do a bit of cross-referencing and independent research there. But the good news is you get to show off and showcase your own knowledge, because if you can prove these things actually happened, then it shows you've actually done some independent research, which is an important criteria for the top level, the level four responses. So what might that look like? Well, one way of doing that would be if representation C, a mythical representation, claims that Lewis Hamilton won the Formula One World Championship in 2014, which he did. I could say, well, I know that from my own knowledge to be true, and I can show off here and really impress the examiner because he scored 384 points in comparison to Nico Rosberg's 317. So I've cross-referenced the claim in the representation that Lewis Hamilton won with my own knowledge, because I can then bring in that he won this many points against this gentleman, Nico Rosberg. So I'm looking at what the representation states, cross-referencing it with my own knowledge, and providing some own knowledge there to support that or to challenge what it says. It might be that it makes an errant or wrongful claim or an inaccurate claim, and then you can still cross-reference that with your own knowledge to see whether or not it's true or to what extent it's accurate. So that's what accuracy means if you're one of my pupils. How accurate is what it's claiming to historical reality? Okay, objectivity, maybe a little bit more complex. Now, to be objective means to not be influenced by personal feelings or opinion when you are representing the facts or the story. Basically, it means to present what happened in a non-biased way. Now, when people tell a story about something they really approve of or dislike, or something that they have a vested interest in, they can be, and quite often are, subjective. So they don't always give the full representation of what actually happened. Or they might focus on certain aspects. Now, this means to present the story in a way that may be influenced by personal feelings, tastes, or opinions. Essentially, is the source fair? Now, to break down objectivity again into a number of mini criteria or sub criteria to make it a little bit easier for you. If I'm teaching you this year, we're going to break it down to four sub-criteria. The nature of the representation. What type of representation is it? Is it a diary extract, a picture, a photo, a secondary source written by a modern historian? The origin, who produced it? That might have a big bearing on whether or not it's objective. If, for instance, you ask me about Tottenham Hotspurs, because I love Tottenham, I will tell you they're fantastic, but I might be a little bit biased and a bit subjective there. The purpose, what is that source intended to do? Is it intended to inform? Is it intended to make you feel in a sort of certain way, to be positive about something, negative about something? What's the purpose of that representation? And finally, the tone. Is it overly positive or negative? Is it optimistic or gloomy? Are some of the words slightly over-exaggerated? So nature, origin, purpose, and tone for objectivity. Here's my example now. Representation B, the mythical representation, claims that Arsenal were truly terrible against Spurs. However, while it's true that Arsenal lost that game, the origin of the source is Mr. History Chappy, so me, a well-known Spurs fan. This means that he'd probably not approach the subject of Arsenal from an objective standpoint and would want to present Arsenal as being worse than they actually were. The use of the word terrible in this context is also overly negative. Now, if you don't know, Spurs and Arsenal fans, we don't tend to get on too well. So if you ask me about Arsenal, I will give a really subjective opinion. I'll tell you all the bad stuff. My tone will be really derogatory. I will make them out to be terrible because I don't like them, essentially. So objectivity is second criteria. The final one, how complete is that representation? Does the representation offer a complete view of that topic? Does it cover all aspects of it, such as the time period in question, the positives and the negatives of the topic, and the successes and the failures? So how complete is that representation? Just bear in mind that not all representations can cover all aspects of a topic. So just bear that in mind. But have any important aspect been left out? So how complete is that representation? An example here would be Representation X claims that the iPhone 6 is the most popular. It is not complete, however, as it does not discuss the range of other phones available, which Representation, by comparison, does when it claims that the iPhone sold lots in 2013, while the Samsung Galaxy sold lots in 2014. So be thinking about the time period in question. Does it show all aspects of that topic? How complete is it? Does it give you a complete picture of what happened, or is it just focusing on certain areas? Just be wary though, representations can be accurate and incomplete at the same time. Now, if you asked me about Arsenal's most recent performance, I could tell you that they lost 1-0, which might be accurate, and hopefully it would be, because I don't like Arsenal and I hope they would lose. But it could be incomplete, because I might not tell you about the previous five games which they might have won. So if someone said, Mr. History Chappy, how have Arsenal been doing? I could say, the last game they played, they lost 1-0. It's accurate, they did. But what I've been asked for is, how have they done lately? And the five games before that, they might have won. So I've been accurate in specifying they lost, but not been complete, because I've not talked about the previous five games which they won. So just bear that in mind. They're not the same thing. I hope you've enjoyed that very, very short tutorial. For any more, please visit historychappy.com. Thank you very much indeed for watching, and goodbye.